Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how you can use Firebase login system in Django project. So you can use Firebase for logging in your Django project, whether it is login with Facebook, Google, email, phone OTP for login in Django. So previously I also created tutorial for Firebase login system. You can see this tutorial before starting this current tutorial. Also I am using this same source code, but I am using it on Django project. You can see I already uploaded the Firebase login system to complete tutorial in this repository. You can use it. So here I am using this two combination of Firebase project to log in to Django system using Firebase. So let's get start. First, here you can see I opened my simple Django project which I already shared in my GitHub. You can also check this project here, like github.com/hackstyle/simple-django-project. So you can find this project here. So all the file of this tutorial will be uploaded here. You can also find the link in description. So now after all this, let's get start. So first back to PyCharm, then click on Django project, app and project. So first open urls.py and here adding URL for logging with Firebase. So let's add, copy this URL, paste here. Let's remove this tab and here change it to login Firebase. Copy this and paste here. Save it. Open views and let's create a function. So define login Firebase request. After that, first return render request, then after that login firebase.html. Now let's create this template. So copy this file name and click on template, right click, click on new, select HTML file giving file name, click on add. After that come to Chrome. So here I am using the same template which I saw in Firebase tutorial. So let's open this login.html, click on row, copy the whole code and paste here, come in top and let's do one thing, move this code to here, paste it and save it. Also you can see here 2 times bootstrap is added. So let's remove, save it. Now let's open this page and see how it looks. So copy this URL and click on run project. Let's open this URL and let's pass URL and you can see our template is rendered and it's showing perfect. Now let's see how you can work with all this login type. So let's get start. So again come to PyCharm, let's open this template again, minimize it and come in bottom. And you can see I already done my coding of everything login system, but we need to change some APIs and login with Django. But first let's see configuration. You can see configuration setting is missing. So let's add the configuration setting. So open Chrome and opening my project. And here you can see my Firebase project. So open this project. Click on web app. Click on setting. And let's see. You can see this configuration. So we need this setting. Just copy this setting, because I removed this setting when posting in GitHub. So copy it and replace this setting. Paste here, save it, again back to Chrome, and let's refresh this page and let's open console. Let's close this, minimize it, refresh page. Now let's see. First click on sign in with Google, and you can see unauthorized domain 127 is not authorized, so you need to add in Firebase Auth section in sign in method. So let's add this domain, copy this URL, and let's open this Firebase console Auth section. So Auth section, and here is authorized domain. So let's add a domain. Click on add domain, paste the IP address, click on add, and you can see domain has been added. Again refresh page and let's try again, sign in with Google, and you can see it's working. Now it's showing account selection, so selecting my account and you can see login is successful. But it's showing error in login, because we need to save this data in, instead of localhost, we need to pass this data to our Django server. So let's see how you can do this, and you can see this error message. So click on OK. Now let's see how you can do this of server part. So again back to PyCharm, and let's click on this. And let's find localhost. So we need to send this data to our Django server instead of localhost, because earlier it's using PHP file, but now we are using Django. So let's see how we can do this. Change this to 127. Select it and then find Control C, Control R, and replace with 127.0.0.1/firebase login save. So replace all this, and you can see it's replaced. Now close this. Let's copy this URL and come in us.py. let's add the URL. So here I copy the same line, just pasting the URL and changing the method. Save it, again open views.py, then here define save and request. So let's return okay, return HTTP response. Okay, save it. Now let's check again. Now let's try again. So click on sign in with Google and selecting my email, selecting my account, and after that it's sending data to 127.0.0.1, but I miss the port address. So let's add the port address also. So again back to PyCharm and find it. Let's replace this, Control C, Control R, and passing the port. Click on replace all. Now it's done. So it will send the data to our server. Save it. Now let's work on this login system. So let's check what is this. So first is sign up with email and password. So let's see, work on this. So first, after clicking verify email and after login with sign in password, we need to send this data. So it's sending to, let's see, Firebase save and passing email, provider, username and token. So let's catch all this data. So open this page and let's print this data. So first is username equal to request dot post dot get username. After that, copying the same line, email. Next is provider, copy this key, provider, token, paste the token and here token, save it. Now let's check value is coming or not. So printing every value, print username, then printing email, provider, after that token, save it, again back, refresh page and let's try. So click on sign in. Let's see again. Sign in and you can see error in login, but it's showing message forbidden and CSR of token is missing. So we need to exempt it. So let's see, @CSRF exempt. Click Alt plus Enter and import this django.views.decorator.csrf.csrf exempt. Import this and you can see error has been gone. Now save it again and open this run because we are checking this value. So again refresh page, sign in with Google. Let's close this. Refresh page. Now again login with email. So try again. Sign in. Okay. And you can see response message is coming from our Django page. And let's check in Django. And you can see it's showing none, none and none. So our data is not coming because we are passing in wrong way. So let's remove this data from here. Copy this data, cut it and pass here. Save it. Now let's check again it's working or not. So refresh page. Let's try again. Sign in. Click on OK. And click on Network tab. Let's make it big. Can see this API or let's make it side. Now it's perfect. Let's make it large and click on this, and you can see data is sending request payload, but let's check, data is coming in not. So click on this and you can see data is still not showing. So again back to, and here we need to set some method. So let's see, how you can fix this. So here xhr dot set request header content type, after that application slash x www dash, then form URL encoded, save it. Now let's check again, it's working or not. Also pass here true, save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and let's try again. Click on sign in. Click on OK and let's check. This time it's sending data in form data. So this time it's sending data in form data. Earlier it's not sending in form data. So after adding header, it's working. Let's open PyCharm. So here you can see this time value is coming. You can see email, username, email and token, all are coming. Now let's move to next step. So again open views.py. Now after data is coming, so remove this and let's open Chrome and let's see this folder and let's back, click on back. Now let's open Earth and open login.php. So here you can see I created my this code in PHP. But now let's see how we can create same code in Django. So we can use Django login system because we are not using PHP here. So let's see how you can do this coding here. So first let's see, we need to use curl, but in Python we need to use request instead of curl. So let's see how you can create a post request in Python. So again open Postman. So here you can see this REST API of Firebase. I already saw this information about this API in my previous tutorial. So you can see if I click on send, it will show the data, but currently it's using invalid token, which means our token is expired. So don't worry, we need only use to code. So click on this code. Now let's export our code. So we are using Python. So let's click on Python request. Don't use Python HTTP client because we are going to use request. So click on Python request and here is our data. So let's copy this. After that, come to PyCharm and here creating one more function. So define load data from Firebase API and taking argument token. After that pasting the code and you can see it's showing highlight error of request. So click on Alt plus Enter and import this name. So select request and you can see error has been gone. Also you can see I am using key here. So let's see how you can get. So back to Chrome and click on project of Firebase and click on project setting, and here you can see web API key. So this is our key. So you can just copy it and paste here. Now save it. So everything is perfect. Let's remove this token because we are taking token input from function. So plus token. Now let's check it's working or not. So server, okay, Firebase response equal to load data from server passing token, print Firebase response. So let's check it's working or not, and here is error. So let's copy this request, open terminal and import pip install request, because we are using request library, so that's why I need to install request. Again come to run and let's click on restart. Again same error. Remove this from requests, import request, and let's copy this, change this to request, save it. Let's check again, it's still not working. Okay, do one thing, click on edit configuration and let's, okay, here you can see it's selecting wrong interpreter. Click on this and select this interpreter because we are using simple Django project master. Click on apply, click on OK. Now let's click on server, restart, and you can see this time it's working perfect. So let's check our API is working or not. So back to Chrome and log in with your email. So first clear it, open console, clear it, sign in, and you can see it's showing message OK. But back to PyCharm, you can see this response which is coming from Firebase and it's perfect, but we need to convert this data into JSON. So currently it's coming from JSON, but we need to convert this data into dictionary. So let's see how we can convert this JSON data into dictionary. So here Firebase dictionary equal to JSON. Let's import JSON by clicking add plus enter, import this name, select JSON, then dot loads and pass here Firebase response. After that let's print this data, save it. Let's check it's working or not. So back to Chrome, again sign in and click on OK. And the JSON object must be a string, bytes, array or none type. So it's showing error. So let's see, back to PyCharm. Okay, here we must to return it. So return response dot text. Now it will work. Currently it's not returning the any data to this function, but now it's working. So let's check again, Chrome, clear console, sign in, click on OK, and let's back to PyCharm. And you can see this time our JSON data is converted into dictionary format, so we can use it now. So again come here and let's remove this. Now we need to use our second code. So again back to Chrome and let's check this code. So here is my conditions. You can see first I am checking does user exist or not. So let's check here. If nothing does keys exist in response of dictionary, so let's check. First is user, you can see user, so copy this. If users in Firebase dictionary, then I will call my method, or else I will return the message like here, unknown bad request, so return HTTP response bad request. Also remove this. Now check second condition here. So let's see second condition. You can see I am accessing the data of user. So let's do here user equal to Firebase dictionary. Now accessing the user object users. After that, if count user greater than 0, so let's see if user dot, so here we need to find the length of list, so len user greater than 0. So here is my second condition. After that else, and here is my next code, which I am accessing only first object of user. So let's see. Also let's check else condition. You can see invalid user request not found. So copy this and here return HTTP response not found. And here you can see I need to access first object, so user 1 equal to user 0. After that my second condition is if it contain phone number, so if phone number in user 1, let's check again. Okay, it's correct. So if phone contain, else I am checking if user email equal to email. So let's check condition here. If email equal to user 1 email, so user 1 email, it's correct. So after that we need to access this provider. So let's see provider 1 equal to user 1, then provider user info, after that 0 index, and second is provider ID, so pass it. After that we need to check condition. So let's see our else condition here. Return HTTP response. Let's copy this message, return it, so save it. Now in else if condition here, if email equal to email, then provider, and now we need to check does email has been verified or not. So if user 1, after that email verified equal to 1, or user 1 email verified equal to true, or add in string also user 1 email verified equal to true. Let's check the message of verified. It's showing only true, so we don't need anything, only adding this true. Or next condition is provider 1. So provider 1 equal to facebook.com. So copy this, paste here, enter. If it is successful, then proceed to login and passing. First is email, username, after that token, and after that provider. So passing provider, and in else condition copy this message, return HTTP response. Let's remove this and remove this echo, double quotes. So it's done. You can see everything is done. Now let's create this method. So copy it and define, proceed to login. Let's add parameter. So copy this, return HTTP response. Okay, now here if you see everything is perfect. Now let's work on phone number. So here in phone number condition, you can see if email equal to phone number. So if user 1 phone number equal to email, then call this method. So again, so copy this method and paste here, and in else condition invalid login request. So again copy it and return HTTP response invalid login request. So that's all for now. So this is our main code of PHP, which I just convert into Django code. So now let's see next step, and next step is our this code. First I am checking, does user exist in our database or not. So again come here and let's remove this for now, and equal to users equal to users dot object dot filter, then username equal to username dot exist. So if user which is true equal to true, then I will save my, then I will follow the login code, else I will follow the database insert code. So here we need to do first thing, like user 1 equal to user dot objects dot get username equal to username. After that we need to do some changes. We can already know you can log in with Django using username and password, but this time I am using login with username only, not using any password, because I already signed up with my Firebase and verified the user. So we just need to log in with user only this username. Also if any user try to access this API and try to log in, it will not work. So this will only work when you are a genuine user and come with Firebase API. So that's why I add this double check condition which will check does user exist in our Firebase database. So here user 1 dot backend equal to Django dot contrib dot auth dot backends dot model backend. So you can use this backend system to log in with your username. We don't need password now. Then after that, just call the method login and pass the request object. So let's add request here, request, and pass the request. Also pass the request here, and let's pass here request, then passing user 1. After that, it means login is successful. Then I will redirect the user. So let's see where I'm redirecting my user in previous code. And you can see after login, let's check login user. After that, I am redirecting my user to home page. So copy it and paste here. So after login successful, I will redirect my user to home page. Or in else condition, first I will create user. So let's see how you can create user. So user equal to users user objects dot create user. You can see create user, then passing first username. So username equal to username. After that email, after that email equal to email, and after that password equal to, you can use password like, let's see, settings dot secret key. So you can use a secret key and make sure you prevent this secret key, so any user don't know about your secret key, otherwise they will try to log in with other user. So you can use this secret key for password. Now after that, we need to log in the user. So let's see, again copy the same code and paste here. So here I add only one condition, which is for creating user. Now you can see everything is perfect. So save it. We don't need to redirect the user. So here instead of redirect, change this to response message login success. Copy it and change here also login success. Save it. And here you already see I am redirecting to home.php, but instead of home we need to redirect the user now to home page. So let's find home.php, select all the home.php by typing alt plus j. Now let's paste the URL slash home page. Save it and let's do one thing, copy this message. So here if login is successful, then okay, here if login successful, then I will redirect my user to home page. Now save it, it will work. So here I remove this redirect message because we are returning the response via AJAX, because we can't redirect the user on AJAX response. So that's why I add return message, and after return message I will use my JS code to redirect the user. Again back to Chrome and let's check it's working or not. So first click on sign in with Google. let's try my email. Now let's write my account to log in with Google. And you can see error in login. So finally one error is coming. Let's see what is this error. Let's check error. The Firebase return any response object, it return none instead. So let's check where I miss anything. In views, proceed to login. Everything is perfect. So let's do one thing, return this message, login success. Also return from here, remove it, and here data equal to return HTTP response data. Also do here data equal to return HTTP response data. Let's try. Also you can use debugger. So let's check adding debugger here. So everything I am using debugger. Let's check what is this error, because I don't want to reproduce the error. Now let's check again. So refresh this page, click on sign in with Google. Now selecting my Google account. And you can see login successful. So this time it's working perfectly. Click on OK. And you can see you successfully log in with your username and it's working perfectly. You can see everything is working. If I try to log out and access this page, home page, and you can see it's not working. So you can finally log in with. Now again open the page. So Firebase, login Firebase. So finally my login code is successful. Let's try with email. Click on sign in. And you can see login successful and it's working perfectly. You can see my email ID as a username. You can also extract these details for username. So my best concept is how you can use Firebase for login with Django and it's working. So I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. Please like our video and subscribe our channel. Also, if you have any question or facing any issues, you can do comment in video.